Hi, John. As we wind down the summer of 2024, let's talk about where things are at right now when it comes to Canada's real estate before we take a look ahead to the fall. Take us through some of the data that came out over June and July. There was this expectation that momentum was going to pick up as rates came down, but that wasn't quite the case.
Yeah, no, we did not see that. The market has been quite sluggish, both for low-rise housing and for condominiums. You know, for low-rise housing, really it's an affordability issue. Buyers pull back, inventories gradually building. But that just means we're seeing fewer homes getting multiple offers, homes sitting on the market a little bit longer, but the market's still moving. The condo market, on the other hand, is very sluggish, very few buyers, a lot of inventory, record number of condos for sale on the market right now in the Toronto area.
Let's talk about, let's just parse those two out. Let's talk about what we saw with respect to home sales, home prices. Again, there was this expectation that maybe prices would go up as rates came down, but of course, rates haven't quite come down as quick enough as perhaps we were all anticipating. Take us through what some of those numbers looked like.
So yeah, I mean, generally, I'd say both in the terms of sales and prices, very modest differences year over year, you know, slight changes in sales, and in some areas a little bit up, a little bit down. And prices, surprisingly, have been relatively stable. They're down a little bit, you know, maybe 2-3% over last year. But given how much inventory has been on the market, especially for condominiums, we would have expected a little bit of pressure on prices, but we haven't seen that yet.
Let's turn now to the condo market. Let's talk about, you had mentioned sluggish sales and sluggish pre-construction sales. If you've got, I guess, whether it's investors pulling back, how does that picture look then when it comes to, I guess, the condo market, those starts a few years down the line? As we know, it's kind of a lag effect there.
Yeah, it is a lag effect. And what we're seeing right now on the ground are very, very weak sales in the pre-construction condominium market. And of course, that will translate into far softer starts in the next year or two. And of course, weaker completions, you know, 4 or 5 years down the road. So any starts we're seeing now were really driven by sales over the past year or two. So there is a lag. So we can't get too excited about or focus too much on what starts are like today. The key issue is, you know, where are sales, where are pre-construction sales? Because that's what's going to drive what the market's going to be looking like in the next year or two.
And what is that looking like when you take a look ahead to the fall? There is a Bank of Canada announcement set, rate announcement, I should say, set for beginning of September. And wondering if that will set the stage, I guess, for more condo activity, I guess, housing in general.
It's a tough question because, again, if the Bank of Canada is right, cutting a little bit more aggressively, it's because the economy's weakening a little bit quicker than they anticipated. So on the one hand, yeah, we might have a slight uptick in demand from buyers in the fall market due to lower rates. But on the other hand, we might see some buyers pull back if they're worried about their jobs. You know, we're hearing more about people losing jobs, job losses, job cuts. And, you know, if there is this economic uncertainty, that might pull some people to the sidelines. So, you know, on balance, I have a feeling it's going to be a pretty moderate market, you know, relatively stable, not too much downward pressure, but also not a lot of upward pressure on prices.
Let's talk about where inventory's at right now. When you take a look at, I guess, how many months of inventory are built up on the market or exist on the market right now, and whether that's, you know, more or less where we should be or in line with previous, I guess, numbers.
Yeah. So when we look at houses, you know, we're in the 3 to 4 months of inventory range, which is slower than normal. You know, typically, you know, we're things move pretty quickly in Toronto, so we're usually around 2 months, if that, and sometimes lower. It's the condo market where we're seeing things cool down a lot, over 6 months of inventory. And again, a lot of this is just driven by two factors. Listings are increasing at a much faster rate than they were in the past because some investors are exiting. And sales are very soft because fewer investors are buying. It's mainly driven by end users these days.
When you look at that trajectory, or I guess that 2025 forecast, and the expectation of where interest rates might end up, I guess the speculation is maybe 150 to 200 basis points off of where we are right now. Do you think then we'll see a material shift in real estate?
Yeah, I mean, 150 to 200 basis points is going to have a significant impact, of course, on the market. I mean, you know, provided the economy's, you know, even doing well, it doesn't even have to be overly booming. As long as there's some stability, yeah, certainly that's going to stimulate demand, both from end users and potentially from some investors who want to get back into the market. Again, the biggest factor over the past year or two has been that mortgage rates have been in the mid fives. And it's tough to qualify at that. At our stress test, you got to qualify at over 7.5% for the most part. And it's tougher to get in. So if you pull back rates by 200 basis points, it's definitely going to have an impact on demand.
You and I have talked about this before, and the expectation of where home prices might end up given that rates will drop. And has your forecast changed at all?
Not too much. I mean, I suspect we're going to be stable over the next 6 to 12 months. Again, I think it's going to take a little bit while, a little bit of some time for the cut in interest rates to work their way through the economy. You know, especially if we have a softening in the job market and unemployment picks up a little bit. You know, beyond 12 months, it's tough to say. But if we see a real rebound, I suspect it's going to be, you know, in the 12 plus month period.